Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
You adults didn't realize you were supposed to answer, did you? My name's Lene Morris, and I am the lower campus principal here at Grace. And we are so happy to see you all. Sorry for the slight delay. Our understanding is that there's still lots of folks trying to park on the upper campus and come down. But hopefully we've gotten the majority of people in, and we don't want to delay too long because we've had our little ones and big ones up here for quite some time already. So we're going to go ahead and get started. I can't wait for you guys to see the incredible program that has been prepared for you today. It's going to be an awesome show. I hope you guys have your tissues ready. There will be some sweet tears, but also lots of laughs and fun too. But before I begin, if you guys would please bow your heads with me so we can pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for this day that you have so graciously blessed us with today. We praise you, Lord, for being the amazing, loving Father that you are to each one of us and caring about us all so deeply, Lord. Thank you for allowing us the opportunity to come together today and worship you through the gift of music. We just pray that you'll bless our time together today. We thank you for every little voice and sound that will be heard during the program this morning. And we just pray that you'll be glorified in all that we say and do here. We pray that your love will be shared and that your kingdom will grow as a result of what happens here today, Lord. We love you and we ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right. Well, I am so excited and extremely honored to introduce our MCs for today. Sage Collier, Kate McKinley, and Marley Quick. These ladies are amazing. I know you're going to love them. And they are going to help us by introducing all of our performances today and filling the time a little during the transitions. So please join me in welcoming them to the stage.
Well, hi there, everybody. My name is Catherine McKinley, and me and my super good friends, Marley Quick and Sage Collier, are super excited to be hanging out with you today.
Thank you guys for coming to celebrate the hard work that these students have put in.
As we all know, school's not all about academics, and this morning is about celebrating the creativity that doesn't show up in grades. And we've got some pretty cool things on the set list for you this morning.
Blending the fine arts programs between our lower campus and our upper campus has been such an incredible way to bring Grace Spirit together, and so we're super excited to demonstrate that with our first song.
The chorus will begin with the song True Colors.
And Kate and I are going to slip in here, too. Don't mind the double casting.
The sad eyes, don't be discouraged, oh, I realize it's hard to keep courage.
In a world of people, you can lose sight of it all. And the darkness around you makes you feel so small.
But I see your truth.
They can say, they can say.
You guys, as I think about summer, it's really given me time to reflect on what an incredible school year it has really been. Marley, how about you tell me one of your favorite memories from this school year?
Definitely sitting outside of the picnic tables and enjoying the sunshine and eating my lunch.
Oh, I am so glad every time that sixth period bell rings and I get to step outside. It is a wonderful feeling. Sage, how about you?
Yeah, I'm going to have to go with Ignite. If you guys don't know, on the upper campus, we have a high school retreat called Ignite. And we go away for about 2 days to a camp about an hour and a half from here. And we just get a couple of days to just kind of chill and just hang out, get to connect with our teachers and friends, not in a school setting. And it's always so much fun because it's really nice to get to know people in a sense that's not in the classroom. So that's something that comes to mind right away. I really enjoy that.
Absolutely. And I know in the past years, I've had really special opportunities to connect with my teachers at Ignite in situations that aren't academic. So I went on a hike with my math teacher a few years ago, and we've played volleyball, and it's a really great time.
What about you, Kate? What's your favorite memory from this year?
I have had a really incredible experience with Grace kind of getting us out in the world and giving us an opportunity to travel. And so this year, some of our upperclassmen, some of our high school students have had the opportunity to go to Germany for 12 days, which was absolutely unreal. And I remember just so many people, I was like, am I really in Germany? Because this is like all of my school friends. This can't be real. But it was an incredible time. We got to do so many new things. And I know that we all got really pushed out of our comfort zones. So it was a really good time.
So as school comes to a close and summer is just around the corner, I think it's the appropriate time for a summer joke, right?
Hit us with one, Marley. Okay.
What did the ocean say to the beach?
Nice to see ya.
Nothing. He just waved.
We've already had several summer moments on the upper campus. Several pairs of sunglasses have made appearances during lunch. Bubbles during Bible class. And juniors were spotted out on the sidewalk with some chalk.
If you've been following the Grace courses for a while now, you would notice a theme.
Elf costume, Grinch costume. But now I'm super excited to introduce you to a song from one of my favorite childhood movies, Frozen. So next up, we have In Summer, composed by Lopez. And keep your eye out for a little one who might like warm hugs.
There are so many opportunities for band and chorus students to excel. This year, and in several years past, band and chorus in high school have had the opportunity to travel to Carowinds, to sing to some adjudicators, and also to ride some rides. This year, the high school chorus received an excellent rating, and we're very proud of them for that. One cool thing about Chorus, similar to Ignite, is getting to just hang out with people that you might not see outside of school all the time. I have gotten to know a lot of my friends specifically on roller coasters, and that's been a ton of fun.
Mr. Stansberry is a big roller coaster guy, and I know he's really helped me and some of my friends get outside of their comfort zones by giving us phrases to scream at the top of roller coasters when we're really scared. And so, you know, you can't be scared if you're at the top of the Intimidator screaming, "Pickles!" So thanks, Mr. Stansberry, for that incredible experience.
Mine this year was, "It's a meatballs!" And I still think about that regularly.
Absolutely. Now we're going to shift from our vocal music to our instrumentals. Bands always have the coolest people. Have you noticed that? Some of my friends, I was chatting with them, and they're like, "Oh, sorry, I didn't reply. I was doing drumming." What? How cool would it be to say something like that? Mr. Stansberry has done incredible things, enabling and encouraging his band students to take on new things. Some of you might have gotten a preview at the band concert a few weeks ago. But here's one of our favorites from the evening.
Next up, the sixth grade band will perform Ocarina of Time from The Legend of Zelda, arranged by the wonderful, the awesome, the incredible Mr. Stansberry.
And keep your eye out for our up-and-coming fifth grade band.
Good morning. I'll let them. There we are. My name is Rob Stansberry. I'm the director of bands here at Grace Christian. I also work with Megan Olson with the chorus. And this is our sixth grade band. For those of you that are observant, it's 11 boys. Every time I say that, people giggle. What is it, guys? What do you think? I should say there's 12 boys, right? We've had a great year. These guys are amazing. Their instrumentation, they're half drummers, half wind, and so it was a challenge. They've already played their concerts with the 7th and 8th grade band at the Upper Campus Spring Concert, but there was one song that all of them decided, and we worked together to get them on percussion. This particular song, they've done amazing at. Learning a different instrument, doing a different thing is really challenging, so I'm really proud of them. This song is very magical, so I'm glad that they get to show it. As soon as they're done, the 5th grade band is going to come up set. I'll talk just a minute more to get them set, and then we'll go. Thank you for your patience. All right, good morning again. So if you were at our Christmas concert, we had the talk about beginner band. Beginner band happens, they get introduced an instrument that has lots of holes and lots of keys and lots of things on it. We spend about 9 hours of practice total, and then we do a Christmas concert. Well, I've had another 11 hours with them. And now we've got our spring concert. As a musician, you learn that there are people who play and who work really hard, and then there are people who have it. I believe that there are several in this group who have it. To give you an example, I don't. I've seen students that rise up in front of me, and I'm like, whoa, it's a natural thing for you, right? And so this particular group, I'm excited for their future. I think that they have a bright, bright future to them. We're going to do a really fun song called Hard Rock Blues. This is going to kind of warm us up and set. But I'm going to warm them up really quick first before we play it. So give us a minute for technical, and then we'll play for you. You'll love it, I promise.
Let's just do it.
All right, here we go. Hard Rock Blues. Ready? Bum, bum, bee, da, da. One, two. One, two. Ready? And. Okay, so here at the end of the school year, you know, the only thing that's on their minds is summer. They've been checked out for a while. Now you can ask their teachers, that's for sure. I've got a senior, and I just keep saying to the boy, you just a few more days, buddy. I just need you to stay here a few more days. But we're going to do a song that many of you know by Harry Belafonte. It's an arrangement of Deo, if you guys remember that song. This is called One, Two, Ready, And. Last song is a philosophical decision. So as a director, I never, ever work them towards a concert because that's too short-sighted, right? We always want to grow as musicians. So I'm the one who pushes the envelope too hard. With my high school band, if you're familiar with music at all, in their spring concert, they played the song by Duke Ellington called Caravan. And Caravan is one of the most difficult jazz songs that you could play at that level. They knocked it out of the park, but I'm always making them stretch. This particular group is about to do an arrangement from the soundtrack of the Pirates of the Caribbean. Did I say Caribbean right? Is it? They've been correcting me for the last month. It's not Caribbean, it's Caribbean when we talk about it this way. So they're going to play an arrangement of that, which actually is above their level. I'm asking them to stretch here. I'm making them go for it. And so I'm really excited. This is a very, very difficult way out of their level song for fifth grade. But they've been doing really well at it. And so I'm excited for you to hear the Pirates of the Caribbean. Ready, and... stand if you can. Walk off the stage. Okay, while we reset, this is what I mean. Yesterday in rehearsal, it was bad. It's like everything fell apart. Then they come to the concert. First one, A+. Second one, A+. Third one, A+. Like, that's what I mean. Musicians who have it, have it. Give them one more hand, please. That's your beginner band. Thank you.
Now we've got some of our even younger Eagles who are going to tell us what they've learned about God's love. You guys are going to love this.
This is our TK kindergarten group. We learned the hard way and split up TK through second grade. And so now everybody can get a good glimpse of all their little kiddos. Everybody asks me every year, are you nervous about tomorrow? Are you nervous about the concert? I'm like, no. They're so cute. And if they make a mistake, you guys are going to love it. No. We have been talking about just different Bible stories in music class this year. And making connections with them and how we can use them to help us in our everyday life. So they're going to sing a song called God's Love. You'll hear lots of different stories from the Bible. And we talk about how God, his promise of protection and just looking after us is always, always with us. And you'll see that theme throughout our TK through second grade singing today with Noah's Ark and some other story themes. So I hope you enjoy it.
neither death nor life, nor the neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
You can tell with this group, we're still learning our singing voices and our shouting voices. They get very excited. So we're going to remember to use our sweet angel singing voices, right, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Another Bible story that is going to carry throughout the rest of this program, Noah's Ark. And we've been learning about God's promise, and he sent us the rainbow and the clouds to remind us of his promise of protection. So these guys are going to introduce the first and second graders a little bit with Arky Arky. We all know that song, Bible school song. If you want to join with us, you are welcome. One of our lessons, I'm sure, in TK and kindergarten, there's that the teachers will tell you is fine motor skills. Lots of practice with our ABCs in sign language. So this is cute to watch them learning how to sign all the letters. I hope you enjoy this one.
Thank you.
All right. We would love to invite you to join us in something that we love doing as a chorus.
Now, when Sage told me that she wanted to do this, I said, Sage, I'm a little nervous about this. I don't want to do it myself. She said, it's okay, Kate. We have an excellent audience. And I said, I sure hope so.
All right, so we're going to need a little bit of energy from you guys this morning. Not too much, though. We'll be kind. All right, so all of our young eagles here, and also we do this on the upper campus as well, we have a warm-up that we do for chorus that we really enjoy, and we would love to share it with you guys. There's three parts. These two rows here and my friend Marley are going to do the first part called Mango. You guys know which one I'm doing yet? Oh, these guys know. Cool. All right.
Hey, guys.
All right, and then these guys over here, hi, friends, you guys are going to do... They're going to do banana.
Oh, yeah. You guys are going to do banana with me.
And over here, hi, friends, we're going to do kiwi. All right, I'm going to teach it to you. It's really simple, okay? Right here, you're going to sing... Mango, 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 mango.
Mango, mango,
mango, mango, mango, mango, mango, mango. See, you got it.
You got it.
All right.
Okay. Now, anyone in this aisle, or if you feel called, you're going to do banana with me. So that goes like this. Banana, 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 peel. And then you do a big clap for peel.
All right. Excuse me. And my friends over here, we're going to do kiwi. Okay, are you ready? Oh, you guys know it. I can hear you. You guys got this. Okay.
Our chorus kids are professionals.
Ready to do it. Ready? Kiwi, 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 kiwi. All right, you guys got it. All right. Now the fun part, are you ready for this? We're going to put them all together and do them at the same time.
We believe in you.
Okay. All right. We're going to start off with just mango so you guys can get the hang of it first. Okay. Ready? Let's do it. All of us together. Let's do it. Mango, 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 mango. Mango, 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 mango. Mango, 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 mango.
Peel.
Mango, 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 mango.
Banana. Peel.
Kiwi, kiwi, kiwi. Amazing. I think you guys are pretty warmed up. And I think our friends over here are just about ready for you guys.
Thanks, you guys.
Nice job.
While the rest of our second graders come up, this song, some of us are going to be singing from the floor. Some of us are going to be singing up here. This is a surprise song. I always like to make somebody shed a tear every year. And the kids don't even know who the surprise is for because I didn't want them to spoil the secret. So we're getting ready to find out. Are you ready? Okay. See everybody getting wet in there? So every year I just like to honor somebody, a group of people at Grace, and I'm lucky to work with a lot of great people here at Grace. So this year, drum roll, we're honoring our special teachers and our staff members at Grace. So teachers and all of those that work with these kiddos every day, this song is for you. And I think we have a little slideshow to go along with it.
Eyes on me. Did you dream? Be Well, the world you've changed is mine, it's true. And I wish you could see who I see in you.
Well, what a morning, Grace. We've had such a fun time hanging out with you.
We have one more special performance from our first and second graders. But first, Kate, what's something you're excited for this summer?
You know what? This summer, Ms. Marley, I am so excited to be representing Grace at Governor's School. I am going to be going for our Spanish program, and I'm super excited about it because one day I want to go and visit Spain. I'm really thrilled about it. How about you?
I'm excited to go to the beach.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm excited about hanging out with some of my friends. Obviously, this time of the year gets pretty busy, but I'm excited for some downtime and some just chilling, playing some games, sleeping in, all of the classic summer things.
And you know what summer means, guys? It means the start of our senior year. Sage, tell me something you're excited about for senior year.
So many things. I'm excited for the senior sunset.
Oh yeah.
We get to hang out and have a dinner as a class and watch the sunset. And that just happened for our seniors, and it sounded like it was a lot of fun.
I'm excited for the senior sidekicks, where we get to hang out with the kindergartners and play outside and do crafts and just spend time with them.
Me too. Oh, and our very last year of chorus. To think all three of us were in chorus when we were little like you guys. So this is gonna be, no more mangoes.
One more year of mangoes. We have one more year of mangoes. One more year to live it up here at Grace before we head out and college? Wow, that's wild.
This time next year, right, guys?
Yes.
There we go.
You guys have been a blast to sing Mango with, and thank you for laughing at my terrible summer joke. But we do have one more performance, so get your cameras out.
We're carrying on with our Bible story theme. First and second grade, we've been talking about Noah's Ark. And so all the songs that you will hear today are related to that. And we have some fun, special things to share with you.
While we have friends coming up to get ready, come to you. You'll see we have some animals. I am a yes. I like to say yes. Friends were like, can we dress up? And I was like, yes. So we have some friends that wanted to dress up as animals. Say they have joined us and they look great today. We have lots of friends playing instruments. A little chaotic. So, yep, you're going to slide it the same way. Pick that up. Really good at this. They listen well. Okay. This is Noah's sound story. No singing. So this is really interesting. All rhythm.
Once was a man, faithful, godly.
Noah, his name was Noah.
God said, Noah, you must build a boat.
A boat.
A boat. You must build a boat. A boat for your family. They will be your crew, plus every kind of animal.
Two by two.
Build a boat.
Give me some instruction.
Build it out of gopher wood.
30 cubits high. 300 cubits long. 50 cubits wide.
Build up the animals two by two. Every kind of creature, a literal zoo.
Creatures that stomp. Creatures that flurry.
Creatures that slither.
Creatures that scurry.
Noah, trust and obey. Listen to the Lord. Follow God's way. Noah, trust and obey. Listen to the Lord. Follow God's way.
We interrupt this program with a severe weather bulletin. We are expecting heavy rains, strong winds, and flood conditions. Take shelter!
Dry ground.
More than a year, no end in sight.
the ground.
Land, at last! What a joyful sound!
Noah sent birds dry land to seek. A dove came back with a branch in its beak.
Tiny said, it's time to disembark. The people and the creatures can safely leave the ark. Noah gave thanks to Jehovah God, who rescued them from the overwhelming flood.
God made a promise with a visible sign, a rainbow in the clouds, clear across the sky.
Next song is a song that you might hear on the radio. It's a secular song. I like finding songs like this that they can relate to, and we can kind of dig deeper and figure out what God might have to say about this. It's called Rainbow, and it reminds us when we're going through storms in life, we all go through storms in life. We've talked about these storms. Maybe we forget our lunch one day. Maybe we were really pokey in the morning. Maybe we got a boo-boo on the playground. But these are our storms that these kiddos are going through, and we just have to remember that God's rainbow, God's promise of protection is always there hanging over our head. And I just love this song and this message. Listen to the words. They love the part where we talked about how we use, what do we use in the rain to protect us? An umbrella. So we're going to hold up our umbrella, but have to remember, we really don't need that umbrella because God's always there like our umbrella protecting us. So I hope you enjoy this song.
Thank you.
Okay, let's give all of our performers one more big round of applause. And how about one more huge applause for our MCs? Thank you, ladies. And on behalf of our PTF, who wanted these ladies to present, we have a gift for our amazing directors, Mrs. Olson, as well as Mr. Stansberry. I don't know where Mr. Stansberry went, but we have a little something for you guys from the moms, volunteers who helped out in our PTF. They wanted to present you guys with a gift for all of your hard work. Let's give these folks a big round of applause. All right, I know on your program you have Mr. Bradley for closing remarks, so I'm not here to do that. I just want to give some instructions for when the program, when we say goodbye and we're done. So we really want to give all of you guys a chance to speak to your youngest performers, take pictures with them if you'd like to, but it creates a lot of chaos in here if we try to do it here before everybody goes back. So when we dismiss, I would ask, and I do this every time, and I know it's hard, but if you guys would let the students get to where they're going first, I promise we'll give you a chance to see them. For the younger kids, for the older ones, third through sixth grade, I wish I could let you see and chat with everyone, but maybe you can give them a quick wave or something. But for our younger performers, we definitely want to give you an opportunity. So TK is going to stay right where they are, down here at their seats. They might be hopping up and down and stuff, but they're going to be in that area. Kindergarten is going to, it's not raining right now, is it? I haven't looked, but prayerfully it's not. They're going to be out on the playground next door, our playground. They're going to head over. First grade is going to go to the gym next door, and second grade is going to stay put right here until the area clears out, and then they can come down and see you guys. Okay, we will give you a little time. We'll try to keep it brief, though, and then we've got to get back onto our regular school business. So at this time, I'm going to turn things over to Mr. Bradley. Again, I would just ask that you stay put until we get the kids where they need to go. Okay, thank you again so much.
Thank you, Dr. Morris. And again, thanks everyone for coming out today for this great performance. If you would please bow your head and join me in a word of prayer. Our Father, we give you thanks for the many gifts and talents you've blessed these children with. What a blessing it is to come and hear them, watch them perform and hear their voices. And when they sing praise and sing of your story, it's just an awesome blessing to all of us. Our prayer each and every day is that every child that walks our hallways would come to know you as Lord and Savior. And whether that's one of those seniors who's getting ready to graduate or one of our TKers, we want them all to draw closer to you each and every day. We pray for special blessings as we go into the last week and a half of school. Please give the teachers strength and wisdom as we move through these days. Bless all that happens at our school and in our community. And we thank you so much for the parents who give us the opportunity to partner with them. And we just pray you'd bless our mission and help us to serve you well. It's in your name we pray. Amen. All right. Thank you, everyone.